Hello, and welcome to my operator guide for Vigil. This is the 8th in a series of short videos that will help you get the most out of each operator in Rainbow Six Siege. Vigil is a 1-armor, 3-speed defending operator from the South Korean 707th Special Mission Battalion. He was introduced in Operation White Noise along with his compatriot Dokkaebi, as well as Zofia and the Tower map. Vigil is perhaps the best roamer in the game, and is a great pick for those who enjoy playing mind games with the attacking team. Vigil's unique ability is the ERC-7, an electronic rendering cloak which allows him to temporarily become invisible to both cameras and drones. When active, the ERC will cause Vigil to completely disappear from the viewport of a hacked defender camera or an attacker's drone. However, the ERC will cause static distortion to appear on the attacker's screen when their drone is in close proximity to Vigil. This distortion becomes more severe as the drone moves closer to his position. In this way, attackers can still have a rough idea of where he is without being able to pinpoint his exact location. Vigil will also still be heard by drones and cameras as the ERC does not mask the sound of his footsteps at all. This is not such an issue for Vigil as he is a 3-speed operator and makes very little noise anyway. As of a balancing patch introduced in Operation Burnt Horizon, Vigil's ERC will also allow him to be immune to the effect of Lion's EE-1D drone. When the ERC is active, Vigil can move freely without being pinged by Lion. This secondary benefit was added to the game as a means of effectively countering Lion's previously disruptive global ability. The ERC has a maximum duration of 12 seconds, and when fully depleted will take 6 seconds to recharge. The cloaking effect will cease if Vigil fires his weapon, performs a melee attack, or deploys one of his secondary gadgets. While this may seem like a redundant point, it is important to remember that while Vigil can be invisible to cameras, he is not invisible to attackers' eyes. I have seen Vigil players make incredibly stupid plays because they seem to think that Vigil was completely invisible to enemies, with disastrous results. On the screen now is how I personally run Vigil. I use the K1A SMG as his primary weapon. This gun is brutally effective at close to medium range, has a decent rate of fire, and almost no recoil. It is this weapon that makes Vigil so appealing as a roamer, as it packs a punch while being laser accurate. I equip it with a reflex sight, a vertical grip, and a flash hider. Like Dokkaebi, Vigil's alternative primary weapon is the Boss G 12.2 shotgun. This is a single slug shotgun with 2 barrels, and can only fire 2 rounds before needing to reload. I cannot recommend ever using this weapon when his SMG option is so good, and I would only use the Boss G for fun in casual matches. For Vigil's secondary weapon, I tend to use the SMG-12 with a holographic sight and a vertical grip. This gun also has an integrated suppressor. The SMG-12 has an extremely high rate of fire, decent damage, and a 33-round magazine, including one in the chamber. It has considerable recoil, so practice is needed to master its aggressive and erratic muzzle climb. Vigil's alternative secondary weapon is the C75 Auto. This gun does more damage per bullet than the SMG-12, but has a lower rate of fire and a lower capacity. Furthermore, it cannot be equipped with any sights or grips. However, since the SMG-12 was nerfed during Operation Grim Sky, the C75's recoil is now far more favourable in comparison, allowing you to land shots more reliably. Since Vigil's primary SMG is so good at close range, you can safely pick either of these secondaries as a backup, since the SMG-12 is no longer the obvious choice. Vigil has access to 2 powerful secondary gadgets, and my personal choice is very situational. The bulletproof camera is always a strong option, and when placed well, it can provide valuable intel to your team. However, it must be placed early in the prep phase, or else Vigil could get caught on sight while deploying it in the action phase. Impact grenades are a roamer's best friend, and on more destructible maps such as Border, Clubhouse, or Skyscraper, they can be extremely useful for creating flanking routes and for diverting enemies' attention. If you're a confident roamer and have strong map knowledge, impact grenades will be a great choice. If you are less confident and only starting to learn Vigil, I suggest taking the camera and placing it in a location with good sightlines near the objective to benefit your team. Vigil is designed exclusively as a roamer and should always be used as such. His kit is uniquely suited to accomplishing the primary role of a roamer, wasting the attacker's time, and instilling a sense of uncertainty in the enemy team. He should never be played as an anchor as he is simply wasted in this role and is not equipped to transition between roaming and anchoring. While Vigil is more than capable of scoring kills as a roamer, he is best used to distract and harass the attackers as they make their way to the objective. This doesn't always involve engaging in firefights, as much of the time Vigil's mere presence is enough to unsettle the attackers. A strategy I enjoy using is to open up a window or destructible wall on the outside of the map near where enemies are likely to enter the building, and wait for the attackers to approach. They will see the broken wall or window and instantly become uncertain because they will expect a runout or a flank, either immediately or later in the game. Good players will then use their drone to try and locate the defender that made the opening, only to discover that Vigil is in the vicinity with his ERC active. This will usually force players to engage in a game of cat and mouse, where Vigil has the advantage. As long as Vigil is careful, he can lead attackers on a goose chase around the map, running down the clock and wasting valuable seconds. Inexperienced players will often ignore Vigil, and this can prove fatal for them when he appears seemingly out of nowhere to take them down. While Vigil is not equipped as an anchor, his gadget gives him an advantage when retaking the objective. If attackers have taken the bombsite or are securing the biohazard container, Vigil can make his way back towards the site without being seen by the attacker's drones, limiting the amount of intel they will have to prepare for your counterattack. In this way, Vigil still stands a good chance, even if he is the last defender alive. Another benefit to Vigil is in the design of his in-game character model. He is clad in an almost entirely black or dark grey outfit, which can actually allow him to remain concealed in darker areas of the map. His mask also completely covers his face, and he is one of only a handful of operators in the game to have no exposed skin visible. His slim, shadow-like silhouette makes him very difficult for attackers to pick out against the backdrop of the map, and you can use this to your advantage if you are careful. Again, Vigil can be difficult to see, but he is not invisible. As a dedicated roamer, Vigil rarely synergizes directly with any other defending operators. However, since roamers work best with as much intel available to them as possible, Vigil would work well with Echo, Valkyrie, Mozzie, or Maestro, as long as these players are communicating. Echo is by far the most useful of these, as his yokai drones can not only follow attackers, but ping them and stun them as well, presenting plenty of opportunities for Vigil to swoop in for an easy kill. Echo is also an anchor, which means that there will be someone on site while Vigil is roaming. This is crucial, as while roamers are useful in moderation, having too many on a team can be detrimental to your strategy. As a general rule, a team should have either one or two roamers and at least two anchors. Vigil's gadget can be powerful in the right hands, and as such, he does have a number of counters. His most direct counter is IQ, who can use her electronic scanner to locate Vigil's ERC while it is active. This will appear on her scanner, allowing her to track Vigil through walls. Thatcher's EMP grenades can temporarily disable the ERC if Vigil is within the EMP detonation radius. Twitch can also shock Vigil with her shock drone, which will have the same effect as Thatcher's EMPs. Jackal can use his footprint scanner to locate Vigil, as unlike Kavera, Vigil's footprints do not disappear when his gadget is active, and can therefore still be located by Jackal's Inox tracker. However, perhaps the most disruptive counter to Vigil is his fellow Korean, Dokkaebi. Her logic bomb can be a nightmare for roamers like Vigil, especially since he excels at remaining undetected by other intel sources. There is nothing worse than to be hiding in a dark corner or making a stealthy flank on an enemy position than hearing that dreaded buzzing noise that instantly gives away Vigil's position. On the plus side, Vigil's ERC does allow him to be invisible to cameras that have been hacked by Dokkaebi, so you take the good with the bad. Vigil is a very powerful defender in the right hands, but he does require advanced map knowledge and patience to use well. If you are not an experienced roamer, I would advise learning the fundamentals of roaming with another operator, since without the skill to roam properly, Vigil's gadget will be far less effective. That concludes my operator guide, and I hope you've learned a thing or two about using Vigil. Comment below and let me know which operator you would like me to cover in my next video. Make sure to leave a like and subscribe if you would like to see more. Thank you very much for watching. And happy sneaking.